Presents a special report, Rancho Chico Days, Under Siege.
That was the scene this weekend following Rancho Chico Days celebrations. Over the next half hour, we'll look at what happened this weekend, how the community is reacting to the two nights of rioting, and what might have caused a community celebration to turn violent.
We begin tonight with a look back at the weekend violence. Bob Marshall's been following the event all weekend long. He now joins us with the latest in this report, Bob.
John, Karina, this has been one of the toughest stories I've ever had to cover. I've been hit by rocks and bottles, pushed aside by police, and finally, the rioters burned our news car. I'd like to apologize to you if I'm a little bit rough on the air tonight. I should probably also apologize to some of my coworkers because I've been completely insufferable in the newsroom. Friday afternoon, when I came to work, I had no idea what would unfold. Since then, I've slept for about 11 hours total. What you're going to see is my attempt to bring into perspective this weekend's events. I'll warn you, I've never heard language this rough on television news before, but I've never covered a story like this before. This is 24 Reports, News Car 4, torched by rioters and engulfed in flames. It capped the two nights of violence that started Friday about 10, when police trying to break up a street party that got out of hand at 5th and Oak were greeted with a hail of rocks and bottles.
We have some drunken animals out here that are tearing up the neighborhood for no particular reason. And we're just not going to stand for it. So we're going to continue to clean out the intersections and we're going to get these people home.
The rioters torched a dumpster and fueled the fire with mattresses, chairs, and anything else available.
I tell my parents I go to Chico State and I study hard and I'm a good student. And then they look at the news and see what kind of things happen to the drunk people around here. I watched this guy trying to put out a fire with a fire extinguisher, and another big drunk guy just decked him.
The street battle moved up and down four blocks, with police trying to spot and arrest the rock throwers. Finally, after 4 hours of attack and retreat, they regained control.
I got two officers in the hospital tonight, and I'm not willing to expose the officers to this kind of bullshit any longer, and I think it needs to end.
But Saturday night, it heated up again with another bonfire on 1st Avenue near Cedar and rioters tearing down fences to feed the flames. When they added a small car to the fire, the police moved in again to protect firefighters.
Negative, I want it down here at the staging area.
Again, the crowd attacked with rocks and bottles, and police swept the apartment complex, forcing bystanders inside. Arresting those who didn't move fast enough.
They tried to hurt us. Number of times our officers got hit and went down. But we were trying to rescue the officer, then they zeroed in on him with rocks, bottles, pieces of concrete.
But some tell a different story of police using too much force on people who were trying to cooperate.
Sir, I didn't know what was going on, to tell you the
put
truth.
Put your arms together, huh? Now, get up! Get up! Now! Get up!
Right there, that's Billy Club. So, I wasn't right here either. I was just standing in another apartment complex. And they came running through it, swinging and hitting everybody.
But others continued on a rampage, moving down the street where they overturned and burned our news car. We shot this video from a second floor apartment window because the rioters mobbed our camera, anxious to have their pictures taken with the car they destroyed.
City participation in it is over. I believe that what we saw happen this weekend is a kind of association of that level of vigor of partying from the people you've talked to will happen time and again if there is a big spring bash. And I think that we should not have a big spring bash because I think it's inevitable at this point that we would get into this kind of violence.
I'm absolutely embarrassed at the conduct of those people who burned our car, but I'm very proud of the work my coworkers have done to follow this story. Karina, thanks for joining me in the field on Friday night, watching my back, protecting me, keeping an eye out for me. And thanks to everyone else who helped me make it through the weekend, including some reporters from one of our competing stations who actually lent me a hand and helped me out. All I can say is it's up to you now. Thanks.
It's really up to the community, whether we've seen it on video or whether we were there personally. Some of those scenes will be etched in our memories. And for the next half hour, we continue our special Rancho Chico Days Under Siege.
Coming up next, the history of Rancho Chico Days and university reaction to the weekend riots.
And now the continuing saga of As the Wheel Turns. Watch the excitement, the drama.
Darling, don't leave. I can't live without you.
And I can't live without Wheel of Fortune.
Get ready for more cash, bigger prizes.
Don't you just love it?
See Pat and Vanna in unforgettable scenes. You'll laugh, you'll cry. As the wheel turns, the saga continues on Wheel of Fortune.
Many professionals in the North Valley now use Pactel Cellular for their business or traveling safety. If you need to stay in touch while on the move, stop by Cellular Plus in the Sky Park Plaza. We have the widest variety of cellular telephones in the North State. And our Pactel Cellular Service Center offers factory installation with the latest test equipment. Prices start as low as $388 in your car or $499 for a transportable. Cellular Plus, 894-1400.
In the Sky Park Plaza, between Rayleigh's and Bowders Oak Furniture. Chico.
My daughter asked me why I don't dress more trendy. Maybe because I like wearing things that'll still be in style 20 minutes from now. Like these shorts. They're classics. Not too long, not too short. Remember, hot pants? Oh, scary. And they're made to last, which means I'll still be wearing them 20, 30 trends from now.
Partners only at Mervyn's for the clothes you love to live in.
It's King Chevrolet's May Madness. Super specials on Chevrolet Storms. Two to choose from, now just $97.99.
We have one 1990 Metro XFI, specially priced at $59.99.
Three 1990 half-ton pickups, now only $10,149.
4x4s, half-ton, one only, specially priced at $11,949.
And 1991 S10 EL pickups, three to choose from, now only $69.99.
Check out our great selection of Mark III and Trail Wagon van conversions.
Unbeatable prices at King Chevrolet.
At the King's Corner, 5th and Mangrove in Chico, where every day is a sale day.
In our special report, we're continuing our coverage of the weekend's riots and the future of Rancho Chico Days.
But first, we'll take a look at the past and how the Spring Festival came into being. It began in 1915 as a university-sponsored event called Pioneer Days. The week-long festival became a time for the university and student groups to open their doors and show off for the North Valley community. But in 1987, student parties erupted into violence. Riots, much like this weekend's outbreaks, forced the university to cancel Pioneer Days altogether. But local business and city leaders resurrected the festival a year later under a different name. Chico State's president has urged student groups not to get involved in Rancho Chico Days, but most ignored his pleas.
And many of those same student groups have been praised this weekend for their positive contribution to Rancho Chico Days. There is plenty of good that came out of this weekend's festivities. During the first night of rioting, many fraternities and sororities were busy working on their floats. Saturday's parade drew thousands of spectators and some 200 colorful entrants. Student-built quad projects brought local citizens out into the sunshine to admire their work. One fraternity even built a permanent quad to provide a play area for needy children. A Rancho Chico Days mixer kicked off the week's celebrations. A children's parade got families involved, and the traditional costume presentations went off without a hitch.
Well, needless to say, the riots of this past weekend have received a great deal of attention. We here at KCPM have received numerous phone calls and comments from citizens who say they are outraged at the violence. Today we took our cameras to the Chico State campus to find out what students are thinking.
Well, it was kind of a big mess. It was a bunch of people standing around waiting for something to happen. I mean, it was just like the riots 2 years ago. And everybody's a little responsible for it. You know, there's people from out of town, a lot of people, it looked like a lot of people just getting rid of their aggressions, throwing whatever they hated, fences, couches. Some guy came up and said, "I threw my dresser on, rah," and he loved it. He thought it was great. Maybe he hates his dresser, I don't know.
Do you think the police are responsible at all?
Well, I mean, it's out of hand. I mean, there was no order, nothing. I mean, nobody's responsible, really. It's totally out of control.
I'm afraid that there are just too many people here, pushed into too small of an area. And 99% of the people have a wonderful time in the parade, in all the events. But I think there's 1% that are really a criminal element.
Embarrassed.
I'm embarrassed and a little upset, you know, a lot upset. It was scary. It was scary to watch them get out of hand.
I think one of the problems is the police came in with riot gear right from the very start, and I think they kind of incited the crowds.
And it's just really embarrassing to students at Chico State. I think the media and the police department, as well as people coming from out of town, had a lot to do with what happened, and I think it really gives students of Chico, and especially graduating students, a bum rap.
And I watched numerous policemen gang up on people that were my neighbors that were just casually, you know, observing for no particular reason. So actually I witnessed a lot of police brutality this weekend that I was very, very disappointed about.
So I think that a lot of it was brought on by the police and by the media, that a lot of it was overdrawn. That they were talking about it Thursday, that there was going to be a riot Friday night, that this was going to happen and all the bad things were going to happen, and it did. They said it was going to happen and it did.
And we're going to explore that issue a little further later on. Chico State University students reacting to weekend events. University President Robin Wilson would not go on camera. He did issue a statement saying he severed ties between the university and the spring celebration 3 years ago.
No one from the university would talk to us for this special report, so we've asked Jane Dolan, Butte County Supervisor and former Chico State Student Body President, to give us her comments. Jane, first of all, what is your initial reaction to the weekend riots?
You know, I feel bad for all the students and all the community members that put so much effort into trying to rework Pioneer Days into Rancho Chico Days and just have the good stuff happen. And now the images of 1990 springtime are going to be burning vehicles and burning fences and not the fun of a parade that I remember growing up here.
You issued a statement earlier that indicated you thought that the problem started long ago, before 1987 riots. What is your perspective of the past?
We had a lot of trouble with Pioneer Days back when I was student president. 1973, we had major problems, and I think that things, when the campus got to be as big as it was, when it was 4,000 or 5,000 students and there were a few hundred that were involved in the springtime, it was easier to control and to predict. Now that we've got 13,000, 15,000 students on campus, all of whom have friends throughout the state, all of whom have about a decade-long expectation of a big week-long party here in Chico, tremendous amount of drinking going on, good warm weather, a lot of exuberance, and alcohol just don't mix, and I think it gets out of control.
Jane, in today's press release from your office, you said that you had hoped liquor stores would take the responsibility for the riots. Could you explain or elaborate on that for us?
No one person, no one aspect caused the riots. A lot of exuberance, youth, people believing they have no responsibility, and an immense amount of drunkenness caused it. I think that we should thank Safeway, because I understand when they were asked to close and stop making sales, they did. And we should look to see if maybe that's the first thing that we should be doing when we know that there is so much drunkenness on the street, to just not have any more sales and cause more problems.
Okay, businesses and the community as a whole obviously willing to pull together. Do you think Rancho Chico Days has a future?
I think it really needs to be analyzed whether this community has the resources to put on an event like that when school is in session. We all love the parade. My nieces and nephews would miss the parade if we didn't have it. Maybe we can scale it down. Hate to give advice to people who put so much work into it, but I think serious consideration needs to be given to holding it outside of the time that the university is in session.
Jane, we're hearing reports that many high school students may have been involved, and you mentioned cooperation by local merchants. What about cooperation by local high school officials as well?
Well, you know, I've been hearing that since I was in high school here in town, that we were always involved and we were here. I think we need to look at that, verify whether that's just people talking, whether it's true, and bring schools and parents and kids involved, because certainly underage or of age people drinking too much is a real problem.
Okay, there's more to this than just beer sales. There's a lot of other merchants profiting from the organization without the students there, and holding it during a different week would cut down on those profits. What are your feelings on that?
That's a trade-off. If we want to remember a community that puts on an event each spring that gets out of control, or maybe just one out of three springs, then we could continue to do this. But I think that the trade-off is to perhaps build the event over years, and I just think holding it when university is in session is asking for trouble, because we are so big now.
All right. Butte County Supervisor Jane Dolan, thanks for joining us on our special report. And we have more coverage and reaction coming up on our special report, Rancho Chico Days Under Siege.
Next, a look at what may have caused the riots and what part the media played in the weekend violence.
My daughter asked me why I don't dress more trendy. Maybe because I like wearing things that'll still be in style 20 minutes from now. Like these shorts. They're classics. Not too long, not too short. Remember, hot pants? Oh, scary. And they're made to last, which means I'll still be wearing them 20, 30 trends from now.
Partners only at Mervyn's for the clothes you love to live in.
Weeknights at 5, join John Carroll and Lorraine Rowe, along with Jeff Peterson on sports and Peter Cherney with the weather. 24 reports, making a difference in the North Valley.
I'm Alex Trebek, and our final Jeopardy category is North Valley Television. The answer is station where you can enjoy a challenging mental workout with Jeopardy, weeknights at 7:30. Of course, the right question is, what is KCPM, TV 24?
Does your car look so bad that you wish people couldn't see it?
Then it's time to visit Miracle Auto Body and Painting. At Miracle, you can choose the best color for your car and pick the paint job to fit your budget. Prices start at only $199.95. And Miracle is the place to get your car's body back in shape, from small dents to major insurance repair. At Miracle, you get a good paint job at a great price. See Miracle Auto Body and Painting in Chico and Yuba City.
Tonight, we continue our special coverage of the weekend riots in Chico. There is already debate as to what caused the riots. Some point to the news media as a key component, saying that advanced coverage may have been part of the problem.
Many out-of-town TV news stations and newspapers covered the event. We want to show you some coverage that ran on a Sacramento TV station prior to the riots.
It looks like we're about 30 feet off the ground. We are on top of Newstar, our live truck. The reason for that: some negative feelings expressed to the police department about our presence here. Apparently, some fraternity brothers called police and said that they did not want us here, that perhaps we would portray Rancho Chico Days in a negative way. The concern is we are at the intersection of 5th and Ivy. This is where the 1987 riot occurred.
Last week, it was the college students of San Luis Obispo that rioted in the streets. Police were forced to use tear gas and fire hoses to control the crowds of students who were simply on a rampage. Now the city of Chico is bracing for what used to be a popular community celebration. I say used to be because several years ago, Pioneer Days were canceled because of riotous behavior on the part of partying students.
As part of our examination of what role, if any, the media played in the weekend's events, we're joined by Mary Andrews, a key organizer of Rancho Chico Days and an outspoken critic of media coverage of Rancho Chico Days.
We will also be joined by Bob Cook, news director at KTXL-TV, Channel 40 in Sacramento, the man you just saw in the commentary, and the man who we've asked to give a media viewpoint of weekend events. We begin tonight with Mary Andrews. Mary, why don't you briefly recap your criticism of the media coverage?
Well, I think the clips just shown sort of speak for themselves. That's the first time I saw the commentary, and now I feel it more than ever. It's, you know, if you keep talking about there's going to be a riot, there's going to be a problem, where is it going to happen, some people tend to accommodate.
Mary, you've mentioned a specific incident involving a Sacramento TV crew and your son. Could you tell us that?
What I told earlier was one of the TV station news commentators was down at the Artisan Fair on Saturday afternoon. My son and his girlfriend were walking through looking at the various things in the Artisan Fair, and they came across a friend who had a broken toe. I said, how did you break that? He said, I broke it starting a motorcycle. And the TV person there said, hey, if you say that you got that in a riot, we'll put you on television so everyone can see you. Whether that was in jest or real statement, we just don't need that type of attitude.
Okay, we're now joined by Bob Cook. Bob, I just heard you kind of chuckle when you heard that story.
Well, of course, I'm not going to sit here and condone any reporter or news crew trying to manufacture a newscast or a story trying to get someone to mention something else. But I have to say this in response to Mary's earlier statement. We're not the people who were hyping the riot. The riots were being hyped by the city of Chico as well as the police department. They were the ones ready. They were the ones that told us on camera that they were hoping that it would be calm, but the police are ready for a riot. The idea of saying that the news media is responsible for this kind of demonstration is what we hear in Sacramento a great deal, and that's a lot of political leaders trying to use someone else's scapegoats for being unable to control their own environment.
Mary, any response to that?
Well, it's very interesting. With my being on a city council, of course, we're constantly talked about morals and ethics and all the various things. I think that goes for everyone. And sometimes we have to pick and choose what type of reporting we do and how we do it for the betterment of the people in the communities. And that's a moral judgment. And it can't be a financial judgment. It's got to be a moral and ethical judgment.
Well, Mary, that's certainly a moral judgment for someone who's elected to a city council or someone who's elected to the legislature. But we don't make that kind of moral judgment. We cover the news. We cover the news as it happens. We try not to manufacture it. And if there's a demonstration or a riot of that kind, we're going to cover it. That, unfortunately, from your viewpoint and the viewpoint of Sacramento, that's one of the problems of being the First Amendment. We're going to cover it, and we're going to cover it fairly. And I believe the coverage on this unfortunate situation here last weekend was covered fairly.
Well, that's where you and I differ. I mean, there's many people in the community feel the same as I do. I can give your names, phone numbers, and you can talk to them. I'm not manufacturing this.
Quick question, Bob. Would you have covered it the same if it was in your community, in Sacramento?
No, we probably would have covered it a great deal harder with more coverage, just as you did here at Channel 24, if it's in that community. But the fact that we are seen up here, this is part of our area, this is Northern California, and more importantly, this is a valid news story, we covered it. And I don't think our coverage, and I reviewed it today before coming up here, was slanted or unfair in any kind. There was a demonstration, it got out of hand, there was rioting. Whose fault it was, I don't know, but I can tell you that I feel it was covered fairly by the Sacramento media.
Okay. After the fact, there's no question, but reporting prior to the demonstration.
Well, I think the reports that we did prior to the demonstration were positive. We interviewed people. We interviewed some of the supporters and the organizers of this fair or event. We reported the fact that they were trying desperately to make this a positive event, that it was not going to, that they were going to try to keep it calm.
Why were those kind of questions even asked, Bob? That's the question.
Well,
part
because
that's
of
tough for me to
Mary, because of the history, you've had demonstrations here before.
Rancho Chico Days had not had a history of any demonstrations.
Well,
there was no need for any of that type of questions to even be asked.
Well, I point out to you that this is the same kind of event that you've had in the past during Pioneer Days, which turned into riots, and I think it's a valid question. If you're going to have the same kind of events over the weekend in this community, do you expect this kind of problem? And quite clearly, Mary, you, the city, and the police department expected to have that kind of problems. And when the police are marshaling forces and canceling days off to be ready, clearly it is a question that is valid in our mind.
Let me explain to you that how Rancho Chico Days is totally different than anything the Pioneer Days had in the past. Pioneer Days was an associated student body event run by the students at the university. Rancho Chico Days is a nonprofit corporation made up of community people who have the continuity to put together the necessary things to combat this type of thing. We are totally working totally with the police department and with the community to try to do the best job we could for everyone.
Well,
we had no intentions of letting anything run amok, and we feel that with the type of questions that were asked by the media, the type of things that were hyped, whether it was a media hype or the police or whoever you want to blame, I think we all are to blame. The media, the police, Rancho Chico Days, the university, the community, we all are to blame, and we need to sit down and figure out how we're going to make this work. You can't cancel every single festival in the entire United States because some people do not know how to act in public. We have to stop and consider, why are these people doing this? Why are they acting this way? And what can we do to keep this from happening again?
Well, Mary,
and we just can't keep canceling things because someone doesn't happen to stick to the rules. And
Mary,
I think it's really important.
I agree with you that it is not the responsibility of one individual group or one organization like the city or the police department. But I am here because of charges that outside media coverage is what caused the event, and that was not the cause
you
of this event.
You took that totally out of context, all right? You took every media person who has reacted the way you have is taking that we specifically said something about just the media. What Rancho Chico Days has said, we all are in this together, and the media needs to be just as responsible as all of the rest of us, and we have to be in there trying to solve the problems instead of creating problems. And that means we all work together.
Mary,
it's
how
no
would you
one
have,
person's
if
problem.
If you were in my position as a newsman and you have a riot in the street of a nearby city, how would you cover it? Would you ignore it?
We're talking about before the fact, not
well,
after
would
the fact.
You have, well, let me ask
now,
you this.
You're asking
this
the wrong questions, Bob.
Now,
I'm
let
sorry.
Me ask you this, because this is an event that was created for the merchants of Chico
that's
and others to celebrate.
That's
if you'll
absolutely
wait just,
incorrect.
If you'll wait just
absolutely
a moment.
Absolutely incorrect.
This is an event
you sit
for
down
Chico?
And look at our bylaws, and you find out what we're all about. It was not created for the business people in this community. And you need to find out your facts before you start reporting them,
well,
all right?
Let me say this very briefly because I see we're just out of time and I want to get this in. The fact is we were invited up here to promote the fact that you were trying to get outside people to visit Rancho Chico Days. And that is why we were here. And I'm sorry it didn't work out better. I wish there hadn't been a riot, but
all right.
The fact is
all right.
There was.
Bob Cook, thank you very much for your comment.
That is the bottom line. We wish there hadn't been a riot. That is a general consensus of everybody involved. We will be back in a moment as we continue our special report, Rancho Chico Days, Under Siege.
In closing tonight, we'll share some of our thoughts and the questions and answers yet to be resolved.
Star Trek fans, it's a star-studded super special not to be passed up. Tune in Saturdays at 6 and you'll get I Only Have Eyes for Spock, I Heard It Through the Klingon, the Live Long and Prosper Love theme, and everybody's favorite, Crusher, I Didn't Even Know Her. Yes, this is one offer not to be missed. All you have to do is tune in to KCPM TV24 every Saturday night at 6 for the original Star Trek, and then at 7 for the all-new Star Trek The Next Generation. Yes, 2 full hours of Star Trek. Order now.
Time was when a hammer was the law of the West. That was before Jensen fasteners came to town. Oh, those hammers, they were fast, but they just couldn't match those air nailers and staplers from Jensen fasteners.
Come into Jensen Fasteners now for the best selection of power tools and accessories. Like this Hitachi power nailer, normally $600, now just $460. And quarter-inch power tool hose, just $13.75 per 50 feet.
Jensen Fasteners in Chico and Yuba City. The best in the West.
My daughter asked me why I don't dress more trendy. Maybe because I like wearing things that'll still be in style 20 minutes from now. Like these shorts. They're classics. Not too long, not too short. Remember, hot pants? Oh, scary. And they're made to last, which means I'll still be wearing them 20, 30 trends from now.
Partners only at Mervyn's for the clothes you love to live in.
Tri-Counties Bank makes house calls. If you want to open an account, if you want a loan, and if you are too busy to come to the bank, Tri-Counties Bank will come to you. We'll send a representative to your home or office during normal business hours to handle all your non-cash banking needs. Need a home improvement loan fast? Call Tri-Counties Bank. Tell us where and when. We'll be there. Tri-Counties Bank. We make house calls. Member FDIC.
We're here to analyze why Honda Accord is America's best-selling car. The bottom line is the Honda Accord is the best-selling car in America because it just might be the best car in America. You can discover all this for yourself at your local Honda dealer.
While preparing tonight's report, it became apparent almost immediately the issues are far from being resolved. Still, the action we take or fail to take on the basis of what we now know may set us on a course we can't change.
Here's Channel 24's news director Paul Unwin with some closing thoughts.
We'd like to leave you this evening with a few observations of our own about Rancho Chico Days and the riot this past weekend. In the business of journalism, one of the most fundamental principles is to never raise more questions than you answer. When it comes to the events of the last 3 days, we have to admit there have been few answers, and yet we are moving ahead with the questions. We understand the reluctance of local law enforcement and College President Robin Wilson to appear on tonight's program. At this point, they probably don't have all the answers either. But the questions remain. Were we prepared for the riots of Rancho Chico Days? Should we have been better prepared? How can we prepare better in the future? Should we give up on Rancho Chico Days altogether? Is the media to blame? In the weeks and months ahead, as we look at these questions more closely, the answers will undoubtedly become clearer. But it should already be clear that Rancho Chico Days, the event, was a spectacular success with a week full of good, clean fun that would do any town proud. It's clear, too, that Rancho Chico Days, the event, is good for the image of Chico and local business. It's also a positive for relations between the college and the community. It's clear as well that although the excesses of some force local law enforcement into an unwelcome confrontation, these men and women who protect us and our community performed with courage in the most difficult of situations. And finally, it is clear, at least to us, that Rancho Chico Days is a worthwhile community event, worth saving. Beyond that, if there are problems, not to solve them is to give in to mob mentality. The same mob mentality that may someday force us to close our parks and playgrounds because we aren't persistent or inventive enough to take care of the local bullies.
That concludes our KCPM-TV special report, Rancho Chico Days, Under Siege. We will, of course, have continued coverage of the events and the future of Rancho Chico Days in our regular news coverage.
We're going to be joining Wheel of Fortune in Progress. We'll be back tonight at 11 for Nightcast. Thank you for joining us for this.